Lord our Father.
Lord our Father.
Hear us pray.
Hear us pray.
As we prepare.
As we prepare.
To play this day.
To play this day.
Give us strength.
Give us strength.
Encourage too.
Encourage too.
To do our best.
To do our best.
In all we do.
In all we do.
Give us strength to play this game.
Give us strength to play this game.
This we ask in Jesus' name.
This we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Family on me. Family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family!
Mr. Mendoza, our athletic director, had been very, very upfront with me from the beginning.
I came in at the peak of the program. You know, we lost in the Division II championship, and, you know, that was great and all, but, you know, there were certain issues, and one of the requirements for us was to move forward was to remove the coaches. Put us on probation, I knew that I had to find a coach that was willing to embrace the situation and be willing to grow the program back from, you know, basically from the bottom up.
I've been coaching high school football for about going on 6 years, actually. Every week is a new opportunity that I look at, you know, and I gotta be optimistic about as a rebuilding process. It's not that it's gonna happen overnight. You know, Rome wasn't built in one day.
We're in the Coliseum League, one of the toughest leagues. Besides the Marine League, I think we're the second toughest league.
The bigger schools, the larger, more successful programs have anywhere up to 75 kids on the program. We have 22 guys on our roster officially, and all of them go both ways. One game they're a linebacker, next game they're a DB. Everybody has to wear different hats. We're asking kids that have never played football before to step in a varsity game and have never played a sport before, and we got them playing both ways against teams that's had a summer program and a spring program and stuff like that. So it's been rough.
As these games go on, we face our opponents, and the players on the team, they're able to get a sense of what a varsity football team is. It really is a battle.
Being started quarterback, it's pretty nervous. Everybody looks at you. You're supposed to depend on your quarterback to make the big plays and secure the ball in every type of way you have to. But I know I have to develop the skills and the fundamentals of football, which I don't have yet, but I will.
Jonathan Hardwick, he stepped in a position where our first-ring quarterback had some issues with his grades, and he wasn't able to play. So he had literally 3 days to be a varsity quarterback and never played it before.
I'm a wide receiver, but like I told my coaches, I'll play anything they'll put me as. I'm ready for anything. I choose football because I'm not gonna get looked at with football, so I wanna be someone. I love it. I've never played a sport, you know, and loved it as much as football.
For me, being a senior, I have a responsibility to, you know, be a leader at practice and at the games. That Monday through Thursday, those days of hard work, you know, and trying to get this team together and rebuild. And, you know, to be honest, it's an honor for me to be able to be a part of this experience, you know, and be able to be a leader on this team and be a leader on the field.
I think we're doing great for the progress. Every game I see things we're doing better. I'm not disappointed in our kids. I'm actually proud of them. You know, I'm very proud to be their coach because a lot of them stories outside of football are amazing. You know, we have kids that are supposed to be in jail, kids that, you know, don't have families and stuff like that, and single family households and stuff like that. And just the fact that they're in school, some of the kids are, you know, be the first to graduate high school from their family. So that to me is the success.
Run, lose, or draw, have fun. Get one in the end zone, obviously.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Come on.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Family on three. Family on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Kudos to Coach Dax, because that's a tough man right there. To be able to become a head coach when the previous coaches had just left, to be able to try to maintain that reputation, like live up to that legacy, is very brave of him. With these bands of misfits, you could call, I owe it to him to be able to go out on that field and give it my all, because I see him putting on his time and effort. He has a family. He drives an hour over here, which is a lot of time.
Okay, future husbands, future fathers, future leaders. Okay, you go out there and you finish your game with dignity.
The student body here, they're so used to the team winning.
We haven't been getting the same support because we're a brand new team.
There's definitely a lot of staff and out there show love, right? But it's not really the same because we don't got those D1 five-star athletes on the team.
Students, they're like, hey, you know, what's going on with, you know, you guys suck. But the thing is, our kids show a lot of heart.
I believe we're a good team and we're young. We got the talent. Don't worry about the scoreboard. Just have fun, do the plays, no mental mistakes.
Like Coach says, it takes practice. You know, nothing is easy in life.
They haven't quit. We're getting blown out. You know, we've lost by 50, 60 points. They didn't quit.
You know, we should never give up because we will get there. Because no matter what, we're a family and, you know, we will always stick together and we will soon get better.
Y'all ready?
Yeah!
Y'all
ready?
Yeah!
Yeah!
The number one thing is after a loss is keeping the morale up, keeping the kids motivated to still want to play football. Because, you know, a lot of guys, they get a reality check, you know, a big reality check when they step on the field and it's not everything they expected. And I just kind of tell them, hey, dude, a loss is a loss. That's on paper. You know, but the real win is you went out there, you fought hard, you didn't give up. You completed the game with pride and dignity.
Proud of you guys, no matter what. All right, let's go.
Let's go, take a break, man, let's go.
To me, when I put that uniform on, I feel pretty strong. I feel like a different person. I've never felt like that ever in my life.
Being able to put on these pads, these helmets, these jerseys, I'm able to represent my community because this is literally where I grew up at, where I live at. To be able to step on the field, go to different football stadiums, and be able to represent Hawkins in the game of football, man, it's really a blessing.
Bless you, my grandma. She just had breast cancer. And I made a promise to myself when she was in the hospital. I said, however many touchdowns I get, it's because of her. And she taught me mostly everything. Church, things not to do, wrong from right.
I thank my dad, you know, for supporting me, because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here right now. Who knows where I would be right now. I'm just a whole different person now, and I have made a big impact into my life.
These kids are able to come out and they're able to be a part of something special. I'm able to become a leader for them a little bit because they haven't been on a football team before. This is sort of an escape from all this outside stuff. There is a lot of violence in the community. So being able to come on a football team where it is united, where it is like a brotherhood, where you do have that camaraderie, it's special. And to be able to be a part of it, yeah, oh my God. It's like, it gives me goosebumps sometimes, you know, on Friday nights.
My future is just to keep on playing football, move on to a college, a university, reach USC. And I just want to be known as one of those athletes who never gave up.
My goal in my life is trying to make it to NFL, trying to help my family, just repay back all my friends and family of what they gave me for my 15 years of my life, trying to take Hawkins High School to a championship. That's my goal, get a championship in high school, a championship in college, and a championship in NFL.
Make sure you're ready to fight. Above anything, be out there, be prepared for whatever life throws at you, all right? I'm proud of you guys. I'm going to say it every time I see you guys' face. I'm proud of you. Each and every one of you guys are very, very special to me. So know your worth. Know what you're playing for, okay? And you're playing for the guy next to you, all right? Each and every one of you has a reason to play, all right? We have so many things we've been through in this short amount of time that we are strong, okay? We've been through a lot. Tears, we've been through injuries, we've been through guys who quit, we've been through people talking mess nonstop about us. I mean, it doesn't stop and it won't stop. All right, so we gotta be mentally tough and physically tough. All right, so you guys know that we have a reason to play. All right, and it's for each other.
There's been a lot of pushback, like, you sure you made the right decision, Mr. Mendoza? You sure that, you know, you're doing the right thing for the kids? And I had to look back and be like, yeah, I was looking for somebody that wanted to mold men. And I think Dax is that guy.
So yeah, I knew what I'm getting myself into from the beginning of this, you know, and I felt like, hey, God gave me a opportunity to step in and do something great for these young men. And so I'm more than happy and welcoming to this situation. I actually wouldn't change it because it's actually developing me as a man and as a coach and as a father to be able to deal with these problems that arise on a daily basis. You know, being an inner city school, our kids have a different reality.
Coach Dax, man, like, he makes me want to become a better person in life, not only in football, because he says, like, the things you do in football translate onto outside things, outside forces, like, in your life. And that's true, because, like, man, the dedication and the time you need to put into football, it's the same thing you need to do when you want to become a successful person in life.
I'm confident that in about 2 or 3 years that we're going to be winning a championship with the team, the kids that are here.
I'm here to help these guys. And whether it's wins or losses, you know, I'm doing do the best I can to make sure I can change at least one of their lives. And football is helping me do that.
No matter what, I love you guys regardless. Let's go, pull it out.
Work. Let's go, baby. Homework on me. Homework on 3, 1, 2, 3.
Homework!